everyone, and this is Laura coming to you today from the Last Days Ministries, and today I'm going to be doing an expose on Perry Stone. Now I want you to first listen to what he says when he's talking to his father. And he has known about this for many, many years. It's not that Perry Stone just found this out a while ago, but that he believes that his father was spoken to by a dead spirit called Al Collins. So I let you listen to the clip, and I want you to think about this. Would the Lord Jesus Christ, and I know a lot of you know this, but I'm going to ask it anyway, would the Lord Jesus Christ put his foundation of a ministry on necromancy? And I hear you all going, no! Like I'm thinking, no! Okay, so here's the first clip.
Now, what happened when you were called to preach? Now, I want to go to
well,
that.
Now that's when I was there at this little cabin, Barry, that I had, me and my dad had built. Dad had helped me in West Virginia, up in a lease area for Iron Creek Coal Company. And I was up there praying and seeking the face of God. And Al Collins, while I was praying, I heard footsteps. It was in the fall, and there was leaves about 4, 5, 6 inches high. And I heard 2 or 3 steps behind the cabin. I'm sitting just like I am now. And I turned and looked around and bent my head like this. And before I could see anybody, a hand reached through the right hand of a man, reached through the side of the cabin, and touched me on the head. And I thought it was an angel of the Lord. But actually, the spirit man of Al Collins had touched me, you know what I mean, and spoke to me about what God wanted me to know, and that the Lord wanted me to know this and that and the other. And of course, I was so overcome by the Spirit that it probably took me an hour after this experience for it to just kind of wear off. You know, Perry, supernatural experiences with God usually stay with people forever. They stay with you all your life. Now, they're not as fresh and they're not as great upon your spirit man as they were for the first 2 or 3 years or something, but they'll be there forever.
I remember when you told, I mean, I've heard you tell that for actually for years about how that you actually, when that hand touched you, you collapsed and thought you had a heart attack and came out of your body.
Yeah.
Paul talked about in 2 Corinthians 12, whether in the body or out of the body, I cannot tell, God knows. Such a one was caught up into the third heaven. And so there are experiences where it's either a vision or it actually is happening. And you went out like being sucked out into the universe somewhere where you ended up, where it was a beautiful sapphire, beautiful sapphire blue. And you described what happened there. You said that you saw a ball of light that looked like the size of a silver dollar.
Oh, yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
And Al stepped out of that and pointed his finger at you, right?
It was moving, Perry. It was so far in the universe I couldn't estimate how far it was. And it was moving with the speed of a, it's like a lightning bolt. It was coming toward me so fast. But when it got to from the size of my fist to the size of a person, but it was a ball of fire, a ball of light would be better, light and fire. And when it got so far from me, it just stopped moving, and the light just vanished, and there stood Al Collins.
And this is the friend that had passed away.
Yeah,
you're out in the universe somewhere,
though.
I mean, way out on the edge of eternity.
And when he spoke his the communication, when he put his right hand out toward me, God let him speak to me.
And he said what?
Let him speak. That's when he said, and he didn't waste any time, Perry.
Yeah, yeah.
See, I wanted to ask him questions, what it was like, Al, what was it like to die? What was this and that? That's what was on my mind.
Right, right.
Because we were such good friends.
Right.
But I wasn't permitted to do that. He looked at me and he put his hand out and he said, Fred,
Praise God.
God has sent me. God has sent me to tell you. Excuse me, Barry.
It's all right.
God has sent me to tell you that you're called to preach.
Jesus.
That He's called you to preach.
Jesus.
And you must preach. You must go and you must preach and you must obey me.
Mm.
And when He said that, the power of God came on me, Barry, and I couldn't answer Him. I couldn't do nothing but just tremble.
Mm.
I just shook under the power of God.
And then but you came back to yourself in that cabin.
And you know, He left one time. He started to leave.
Uh-huh.
And then something stopped Him and told Him He wasn't finished. And He turned around and said it the second time. Said the same thing.
Wow.
And that let me know. And it was Al Collins. There's no spirit.
Yeah.
It was the soul of Al Collins.
Now, you had an experience, too, where... you saw into heaven, and you saw books in heaven, and they actually had photographs in them, or what looked like photographs of the ministry of Jesus.
Yeah, they were.
Can you remember that?
The title of one of them.
So tell what happened, though. That's what's interesting.
Barry, it was, I walked into this, I was praying and just carried out in the Spirit. And I walked
in. Now explain that for people that don't understand. When you say carried out, what happens?
Well, the Holy Ghost has come on me so great. The Spirit of God moves on you so great that He can do what He wants to do. He can show you
right. Anything
He wants to show you. So in the Spirit, man, I was on my knees in prayer. But in the Spirit, my inner man walked into this great library.
Literally, you saw this.
Yeah, into this great library. And Perry had books. The width of them was about like this. They were about this high.
Was it about three and a half,
yes.
3 feet maybe? 3 feet?
Yeah, they were. And one of them was called The Mighty Acts and Words of Jesus. And then there was another book there about Jesus.
Uh-huh.
But I felt led to look at The Mighty Acts and Words of Jesus. So I pulled it out, laid it in this table.
Uh-huh.
It was a table with just... the most beautiful, glistening white cover. And I laid it down. And when I opened the book, on the page, it said, I opened the title page and it said, The Mighty Acts and Words of Jesus. And I thought, well, I've never seen that book. So I started opening it up. And as I did, there was great pages of His preaching. And...
Yeah, so you could read it and see it.
Yeah, yeah.
So what do you think it was, Dad? Do you think it was the Holy Spirit while Jesus was on earth actually captured somehow for people to see one day everything that He did?
John said, and there are many other things which Jesus did, the which, if they should be written, every one, I suppose that even the world itself.
Wow, that's
John
right.
John 21.
So what did you see? Like what? I mean, you saw...
Oh, it was the Sermon on the Mount. Instead of just Matthew 5, 6, 7, it was other preaching that He did that was with that.
In other words, when the Bible says every word man gives an account of on that day, He literally has words, apparently, in books or something.
So the Holy Ghost put in the Bible what He wanted us to actually see and read of the words of Jesus. But Perry, there are there could be millions of words of Christ. And sermons of His, just like with yourself. Now, there's been times when you'd start preaching in your meetings that I would marvel because I knew what you were saying was not on notes. You weren't quoting from notes. And I believe, Perry, that that's where that a lot of preachers get so inspired today that God just pulls some of the preaching of Jesus that's not in the books of the New Testament and just puts it in their mouth. And they preach it, and you know, they're saying, and people are saying, where in the world did that come from? I never heard of that before.
Okay, so you've heard that particular part. Now I'm going to let you listen to a particular link where Perry Stone is on GBN, and he's praising TBN. He's saying that the people over in the Muslims are hearing the gospel. You're never going to hear the gospel on TBN. not once. You'll hear the word of faith garbage and the prosperity garbage, but you're certainly not going to hear the gospel. So here is Perry Stone talking about how wonderful TBN is.
The email and did a follow-up. There are Muslims under 30 years of age watching TBN who are coming to know the Lord. They love the Manifest program because it comes from Israel where they can't visit.
Right.
So they get to see the land, you know, because it's big in Islam.
Sure.
And I just wanted you to know there is a real impact, Paul, that TBN has outside this country. I don't think a lot of your people realize that watch TBN.
Okay, so the next piece of film I'm going to show you is people dancing in Perry Stone's church around the Ark of the Covenant. And after I play that piece of film, I will be commenting on it. Okay. Okay, so there you saw Perry Stone's people dancing around the Ark of the Covenant like it absolutely means nothing. It actually looks really like blasphemous, to be quite honest with you. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be reading a particular article that I think is very good. It's called What is the Ark of the Covenant? Now, it's only a short, not a very long article. And the answer is this. God made a covenant, a conditional covenant with the children of Israel through his servant Moses. He promised good to them and their children for generations if they obeyed him and his laws, but he always warned of despair, punishment, and dispersion if they were to disobey. As a sign of his covenant, he had the Israelites make a box according to his own design in which to place the stone tablets containing the Ten Commandments. This box or chest was called an ark and was made of acacia wood overlaid with gold. The ark was to be housed in the inner sanctum of the tabernacle in the desert and eventually in the temple when it was built in Jerusalem. The chest is known as the Ark of the Covenant. The real significance of the Ark of the Covenant was what took place involving the lid of the box known as the mercy seat, quote unquote. The term mercy seat comes from a Hebrew word meaning to cover, placate, appease, cleanse, cancel, or make atonement for. It was here that the high priest only once a year, in Leviticus 16, entered the Holy of Holies where the ark was kept and atoned for his sins and the sins of the Israelites. The priest sprinkled blood of a sacrificed animal onto the mercy seat to appease the wrath and anger of God for past sins committed. This was the only place in the world where this atonement could take place. The mercy seat on the ark was a symbolic foreshadowing of the ultimate sacrifice for all sin. The blood of Christ shed on the cross for the remission of sins. The Apostle Paul, a former Pharisee and one familiar with the Old Testament, knew this concept quite well as he wrote about Christ being our covering for sin in Romans 3:24-25, and are justified by his grace as a gift to the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God has put forward as a propitiation by his blood, to be received by faith. Just as there was only one place for atonement of sins in the Old Testament, the mercy seat of the Ark of the Covenant, and there is also only one place for atonement in the New Testament and current times, the cross of Jesus Christ. As Christians, we no longer look to the Ark, but to the Lord Jesus himself as a propitiation and atonement for our sins. So now that you've heard about what the Ark of the Covenant is really about, what you're seeing there is just absolutely vile. I mean, the Ark of the Covenant was considered to be extremely, extremely holy. The Levitical priest only went in there once a year. It was for the Old Testament. It was a shadow of what was to come for our Lord Jesus Christ. And for them to be dancing around like some kind of weird pagans dancing around the Ark of the Covenant, it's so disrespectful. It's so just unholy and unbiblical. It's wicked. It's wicked beyond belief. Beyond belief. So that's all I have to say about that. And now I'm going to show you another piece of film. And this is even more disgusting.
When hinges creak in doorless chambers, and strange and frightening sounds echo through the halls, whenever candlelights flicker, where the air is deathly still, that is the time when ghosts are present, practicing their terror with ghoulish delight. Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now.
Okay, everyone, so you've seen everything that I've shown you there, and there is a lot more information out there, but this is some of the things that I just wanted to show you. Perry Stone's ministry is not based on a biblical basis. It's based on necromancy. And as I've shown you through the video, you've seen pictures of Perry Stone throwing up the Freemason signs, the El Diablo signs, all of this kind of stuff. Just remember, brothers and sisters, there are people who claim to be Christ, but they go under the guise of Christianity, but they're actual Freemasons. And so what they've done, and you'll see all the way through that video, it's all kind of inverted, like the inversion of the fact that the ministry was found on the dead man called Al Collins, and he tried to make that sound very spiritual by using scriptures all out of context. Then he gets his church to dance around the Ark of the Covenant, which is extremely blasphemous, say the least, and of course makes out that that's fine and it's biblical. And then you've got just so many things is wrong with this. And then you've got the haunted house, people dancing around in a haunted house with all this demonic stuff around. The whole way through the scripture, all you're going to see there is satanic and occult, satanic occult, satanic occult. Especially when he throws up, you'll know because he keeps throwing up the Freemason sign, and You know, also, you know, when he was talking about Al Collins, he said he saw like a lightning bolt. Now, that's one of the symbols of Satan, okay, that he was thrown from the earth like a lightning bolt. And of course, that was not the Holy Spirit showing him Al Collins. That was actually Satan. Either it was Lucifer or it was an unclean demonic spirit that was showing him that. And the fact that he's, you know, that Perry Stone said, oh, amen. Oh, and I know he was crying, and don't get me wrong, it's sad to see people cry. But even though he was crying, it means nothing. The man did not hear from God. It's actually occultic what he was involved with. Not scriptural. None of that was scriptural. None of what I've shown you there is scriptural at all. And the fact that Perry Stone goes on to TBN and tells people that they get to hear the gospel from TBN, I mean, that even in itself should be a huge alarm bell to stay far, far away. And also, Perry Stone is all into the tithing, giving money, you know, making people feel guilty if they don't give their money. I don't have an actual clip of it, but I've seen it. So this is very important that you know about this particular man, because a lot of people think he's terrific, but what they fail to do is they fail to go and look and do research and find out the truth. We are to test everything by the word of God, and that includes me. You test me. You go away and say, okay, so I've looked at Laura's video. Is it biblical? Is she wrong? And go and test me by what I say. That's all I'll say. Because I love you guys, and I want you to go specifically by scripture. So anyway, that's all I wanted to say. And I hope this video has blessed you. And feel free to leave messages underneath as usual. And I just want you to know, to all the people that do listen to this video, I really do appreciate your support and your love and your kindness. And I will continue to do this ministry as long as the Holy Spirit has me doing it. So anyway, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. And may the Lord let his light to shine upon you. God bless, and goodbye for now. Bye-bye.